Hello and welcome to Total Football Analysis. In this video, we will explain Tuchel's tactics at PSG and analyze how Thomas Tuchel got the better of Lucien Favre and his Borussia Dortmund side. Tuchel had to improvise with Marco Verratti, Thomas Meunier and Thiago Silva suspended, while Kylian Mbappé was only fit enough to make the bench. Pablo Sarabia was chosen instead of the young Frenchman up top, while Thilo Kehrer and Marquinhos formed the back line alongside another newcomer into the lineup, Juan Bernat, and Presnel Kimpembe. Finally, Leandro Paredes accompanied Idrissa Gueye in midfield that closed a trademark 4-4-2 formation. On the other side of the pitch, Favre lined his side up in a 3-4-3 system that mirrored the one used at Signal Iduna Park when they managed to beat PSG in the first leg game. The biggest change for PSG that happened between the second and the first game was the change in formation. The French giants decided to go back to what they know works and were deployed in a 4-4-2 system that transformed into a 4-2-2-2 or even 3-4-3 when progressing the ball across the pitch. This fixed a lot of issues from the first game, mainly because of the functionality of the forward line. With Cavani and Sarabia constantly pinning the center backs and forcing them towards their own goal, Neymar and Angel Di Maria would often find space between the lines to receive the ball in dangerous zones, as can be seen in this image. And this was practically the main theme of the whole first half, as PSG dominated the ball and mostly dominated the proceedings on the pitch. Of course, with the wingers constantly cutting inside and positioning themselves cleverly behind the midfield line, Tuchel's team could easily find their targets. But a couple of things played right into their hands. Firstly, Borussia Dortmund's 5-4-1 defensive system was too flat and left huge gaps to be exploited vertically. You can see in the image here how, without a staggering line, the defensive shape doesn't really offer that much cover, and PSG can easily position their players in advantageous zones. The idea from Favre was to box in PSG's double pivot, forcing Tuchel's team to go out wide, and then collapse on them when they were pinned against the side of the pitch. But with those structural issues, they still allowed their opposition to penetrate them centrally. The second thing that was constantly lacking in their approach, as opposed to the first game in which this was utilized much better, was the ineffective pressing tactics. Borussia Dortmund pressed high up the pitch if the ball was recycled all the way backwards and PSG were being forced into their first third. But as you can see from the sequence here, they would often leave gaps which allowed PSG to easily bypass the pressing squad and progress the ball all the way from the back. If, however, Dortmund managed to box the midfield in and tighten up their lines, one of the pivots would regularly drop into the back line to form a back three with two of the center backs, and he would help advance the ball up the pitch, usually sending it out wide before making a darting run from the deep himself. PSG were consistently getting into the final third with no major setbacks, and their first half dominance was rewarded with two goals that ultimately sealed the deal. But it was also their ability to defend well that ensured they would keep the clean sheet. During the defensive phase, PSG swapped between various different systems in order to minimize the damage that could be done by the opposition. Mostly, they operated in a 4-4-2 mid-block that focused on successfully shutting down all the passing lanes leading into the middle third. If the ball was recycled between the center backs and the fullbacks were successfully forced back to assist the build-up, PSG would often switch to a 4-3-3 when engaging into the press and then deployed a rather aggressive pressing approach that saw them collapse on the opposition and hunt for the ball. This, in turn, led to them engaging into duels higher up the pitch, which was often the case in the first half when 12 of their 34 recoveries happened in the opposition's half, and Borussia Dortmund registered 30 own half losses in that period as well. You can see Dortmund's losses in this graphic and note how a large percentage of those first half losses happened in Borussia Dortmund's own half. It doesn't surprise that PSG ended the half with a PPDA value of just 7.4, highlighting their aggressive approach. This means that Tuchel's side only allowed 7.4 passes per defensive action on average. Borussia Dortmund, however, did have a couple of tricks up their sleeve that they tried utilizing from time to time. The most prominent one was movement manipulation. Their forwards would regularly drop deeper in order to receive the ball and pull a defensive player out of his shape. That would then leave the flanks open for a penetrating through ball to be deployed. You can see an example of that in this image, as Hakimi can be sent into space with PSG's defender pulled out of their defensive line. Similarly, Erling Haaland was also one of the targets on the night, and Favre's tactics were also to find the young attacker with long balls and use his strength to win the first ball, lay it off, and then sprint back into space that was created by his movement. Observe such a sequence of play in this image. Haaland drops, pulls one of the defenders, and that creates space. Meanwhile, one of his teammates bursts right into that area and can then receive the ball from another player, since Haaland could successfully lay it off after winning the duel. But Borussia Dortmund had some serious problems in penetrating PSG's solid defensive tactics. The reason behind that was that their striker was constantly isolated and they couldn't find him often enough throughout the night. The wingers Thorgan Hazard and Jadon Sancho would either drift wide in order to stretch the defensive line or would drop deeper to receive the ball, but that made it easy for PSG to just double down on Haaland and keep him boxed in between the center backs almost throughout the whole game. The idea behind their tactics, however, was a simple one on paper. When one of the forwards drop into their half space to collect the ball, they can turn and create an overload along with their respective fullback on the opposition's defender. In theory, that would look something like this. But due to PSG's aggressive pressing tactics and compact defending, this was much easier said than done. At the end of the day, with an expected goals total of 0.98 compared to the opposition's 0.31, Tuchel's side are deserved winners of this game.